Hi guys, thank you for joining our video class for herbology. This is our week one definitions video class, and today we're just going to talk about like some basic terms that we really need to know to get into next week's lessons. But I just wanted to let you all know that whenever we do these video classes, I will not be covering any material that was out of the reading assignments for every week. So this week, the reading assignments I've already given you, I won't be discussing those in this class. However, on Saturday, whenever we do our recap, check-in, Q&A session, I will talk about it then. I just want to keep the two classes separate, the assignment days and then the video days. So today we're just doing our definitions, no recapping of the reading. Also, I really wanted to address this in particular. If you've been keeping up with class and the announcements I've made, I asked that everybody join our sister server so that you could have access to our library that Mystique has gone to so much trouble and effort and work. She has done such a phenomenal job to put that library together. So I asked everyone to join that. As the week was progressing, it seemed that there were a lot of people and concerns, maybe not liking the flipping back and forth between the server. I know it's not, perfectly seamless. Moving forward, I am going to make use of that library. I know some people aren't thrilled about that. I'm not going to continue linking the texts over into our academy. And the reason why, and I really wanted to address this verbally, the reason why is because Mystique has gone to a lot of, guys, when I say she has put in hours and hours and weeks, days and weeks, she has worked so hard to gather all these materials for us. And she's put them on that other server for us because there's just not room for it in our academy. I just don't feel comfortable taking her sources and sharing them here when she has made them so readily available for us somewhere else. We really need to respect what she has set up and use the system the way she set it up. And like I said, I know not everyone's thrilled about that, but it's really the most appropriate and the best way for us to do it. So, if you would please, if you want to do the reading assignments, and remember, all of this is completely optional. You do not have to do any of this. If you prefer to just do the reading assignments that I link that are for other sources outside of the sister server, that is totally okay. That is absolutely up to you. You are in no way obligated to do any of the assignments. But if there is an assignment that is in the sister server's library, I am going to send you to that sister server. So please make sure that you've joined it. It is actually pretty straightforward. Once you get into that sister server, you just want to find the roles channel and make sure that you have selected library pass. And you'll have access to that library. Also, guys, please remember that there are tons of resources on there, and she is not even done with it yet. There are so many things for you to use on there, especially for, baby witches. And I mean, even those of us that aren't considered baby witches anymore, there are so many things that we can utilize in there. Even if you're not using it for this class, it's a great resource for you, and I highly, highly, highly suggest you go and be a part of it anyways, even if it's not for this class. So again, I'm sorry to disappoint anybody. I really am. And I did talk to Mystique about it. I talked to Johan about it. And this is just the best way that I feel comfortable doing it that's fair to Mystique as well. So, I'd appreciate it if you guys could just follow that sister server and just make sure that you know where the library is. Like I said, it's a great resource regardless. But again, totally up to you if you'd rather not flip back and forth for the reading assignments. That's totally up to you. I don't mind at all. I know that a few people voiced some concerns with not wanting to flip back and forth. But for the sake of our class, I am going to utilize it. I don't know that we'll use it every week, but we will be utilizing it here and there. So, again, please make sure you're following our sister server, that you're a part of that. And, also, guys, not to just like work this in, but it's a really fun server anyway, because there's more games on there, there's more clubs, like there's a lot over there, guys. Like you want to be involved regardless. Anyway, okay, so there's my little plug. Needed to make sure you all knew about that, because moving forward, I just didn't want to have any more issues about it. And please know, I'm not trying to in any way disregard anyone's feelings or be rude in any way at all, but out of respect for Mystique, we really need to use the system the way she has it set up. So let's make sure we're doing that. Let's go ahead and start with my own introduction for myself. I know I gave one textually in the academy, but I wanted to just verbally introduce myself. My name is Carla. I am the herbology professor here. I am also the Sabbats professor, the head of households for the Dryads, and a moderator on the server. And you guys can reach out to me anytime you'd like to. If you would like to contact me in the academy, please feel free to do that anytime you like. Or you can email me. I've set up an email address that is just for the academy. It's tmaprof.carla@gmail.com. And please note, now some of you already know this about me. Probably actually quite a few of you probably know me. I am a mom. I've got a toddler. I also own my own business, so I am busy a lot. But I do typically keep my phone pretty close by me. So sometimes I may be unavailable, but please know I will get back to you as soon as I possibly can. I promise I am not ignoring you. I will not ignore anyone. If I get a message from you, I promise I'll get back to you. Also, if you wanted to know just a little bit about me and my path, I am what I consider a green hedge kitchen witch, and I take a little bit of everything from other pathways as well, so you could consider me eclectic. But the green and hedge pathways are part of my ancestry. My great grandmother was a green witch, and my great 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 aunt was a hedge witch, and that's very important to me to keep that practice going in my family. But also, I've added in the kitchen witch for myself, because that is just somewhere that I thrive and feel most comfortable. It's very important to me, and it's a very spiritual practice for me. And also, let me take a chance to let you all know that we do have a class aide for herbology, and it is Hannah. She is absolutely wonderful, so, so sweet, and she's incredibly knowledgeable as well. She is currently running our Eco Tips channel for our class, and she will be interacting in our class as well as myself. Actually, when it comes to doing our Saturday recap days, we will be alternating who hosts that. So this Saturday, I'll be hosting your recap, and she'll be doing the following Saturday, and we'll kind of be switching off. We'll see how that works best. We're not really sure how we're going to keep it up just yet, but as of right now, we're planning just to switch off. So we are both going to be available for you. Please feel free to reach out to her as well. She's really, really sweet. You're going to love her. All right, let's go ahead and get into our materials. This is probably going to be a pretty quick video class. I just wanted to cover these basics because, as I said earlier, it's really important that we have these covered for next week. And it's just a few basic terms, but they're fairly important. So I want to talk about herbs. Herbs are obtained from the leafy parts of a plant, and specifically herbaceous plants. Herbs is actually short for herbaceous, obviously. Herbaceous plants are plants that have no woody parts above the ground. So they wouldn't have wooden stems or like a trunk, nothing like that. Those are not herbaceous plants. So no woody parts. This is best demonstrated through the photos here. If you'll notice on the left, and as you can tell, that's basil, and then we have rosemary and peppermint in order there. And all of these plants have green stems, no wooded parts above ground. So that's very, very important. And it's very important to note that for herbs, you would obtain those through the leaves. The magical properties of that plant are found in the leaves. Now let's talk about spices. Spices are actually a little bit different. They're obtained from the roots, flowers, fruits, seeds, or bark of the plant. They're typically native to warm tropical climates. And these can be any kind of plants. They can be woody, they can be herbaceous, it doesn't matter. And so let's take, for example, the first photo on the left is of cloves, and cloves are actually flower buds from a tree. Then we have cinnamon in the center, which is a tree bark from the cinnamon tree. And then on the right, you have the root of a ginger plant. So all of them come from different pieces of the plant. It's so important when you're using your plants for magical purposes that you know where to find the magical parts. So just remember, spices and herbs are different and they come from different parts of the plant. Now, another thing to note is that some plants can be both. They can be herbs and spices. Let's take the plant on the left. This is Coriandrum sativum, also known as coriander. Now, on the left in that picture, you see the coriander seeds. On the right, you see cilantro. Now, both of those parts have magical properties, but they come from different parts of the plant. But we also use some magical ingredients, I'm going to say, that are neither herbs nor spices. They are minerals. And this example is salt. Now, that being said, I'm not going to use a lot of minerals in our discussions because they're not very common for us to be able to obtain naturally. Typically, we purchase salt, and it is considered part of our herbology class, and it is a magical ingredient, but it's not really a plant. It is a rock. So, although we won't be addressing it much, I'm not going to really give you the definition of a mineral. Just know that some magical ingredients don't fall under either one of those categories. Okay, let's talk about close practice plants. If any of you are keeping up with our culture club in the academy, then you know there are a lot of close practices. And close practices are practices that are not open to anyone that is outside of that culture, religion, etc. These plants work the same way. So the photo in the example here, the photo is of white sage. And white sage is only meant to be used by the indigenous Americans. And so these closed practice plants are plants that should not be used by anyone not part of the community in which it is considered sacred. And if you would like to go and join our culture club, you can get more information on what to do with those closed practice items if you do get them. But for example, with the herbs or spices that you might receive that are closed practice, and we're going to address them more next week, but just to get us started, if you do obtain those, the best way to respectively not use them, if you're not part of that culture, is either to bury them or to gift them to someone who is of that culture or community. Okay, also, let's talk about poisonous plants. One thing that people tend to always think is that if it's poisonous, that must mean that it will cause deadly harm. That is not necessarily the case. A poisonous plant is any plant that could cause harm or be deadly to an organism that comes into contact with or ingests it. So it could just be that it causes some sort of reaction on your skin or within your body or some sort of hallucinogenic properties. Those are technically considered poisonous plants. So if you look at the photo on the left, that's hemlock. In the middle is mandrake, and then you see belladonna or deadly nightshade on the right. Those are just a few examples of poisonous plants. And next week, we're going to talk a lot about more specific poisonous plants, but those are just some examples to get you started. And those are all the terms that I really wanted to go over, only because, like I said, we're going to be discussing them in depth next week. I just want to make sure you know exactly what I'm talking about when we start talking about them. So, for next week, what you can expect on Monday, I'll be releasing our weekly assignments just as I did this week. There will be some reading assignments, but I'm also actually going to give you a few homework questions to go with that. And those won't be due on Monday. They'll be due, I believe it's the following Sunday. I'll double check the syllabus, and when I post it on Monday, I'll be very clear about when it's due because I can't remember. On Wednesday next week, I'll post our next video class. And then next Saturday, we will still hold our recap, check-in, Q&A session. And that one will be with Hannah. Like I said, I'll be doing the one this Saturday, and Hannah will be with you guys on next Saturday. And I really don't know if we're going to do, I'm going to try for my Sabbaths class this week, I'm going to try to do a voice class for the recap. I don't know that I'm going to do that with herbology. I'm going to see how it goes, and if it goes well, I'll do it for herbology as well. Just we're going to have to play with it a little bit to see what method works best for you guys and for us as well. So we'll see how that goes. But let me know if you all like or dislike these video classes, if this is easier for you, or if I can do something to make them better. I want to make sure that you all are having the best experience you possibly can, and that these are easy enough for you to navigate through. I think that's all I've got for you today, but just make sure that you're with us on Saturday. I believe 4 p.m. is our herbology check-in time on Saturday, so I'll be there for that. And I'll be available just to answer questions. I might ask a few questions. I'm going to check in with you guys and just see how the week has gone for you, not only in our class, but just across the academy, how your first week of classes has gone. And we will discuss all of that on Saturday. Thanks, guys.